Alright, now let's add a movie. And for this, I'm going to create a new function, add movie, where I here need the name and the score. Alright, and I'm going to just, I'm going to create a new movie, I guess. New movie. And I'm going to say name, yes, score, and ID. For the ID, very simple. ID, I'm going to get movies. No, let's make a string, movies dot length plus one. Very simple. I'm gonna get how big is this array plus one. That'll be the array, the ID. Done. Comma. Fuck. Wait. Comma. Done. All right. Const new movie. And now what we need to do is movies push new movie. And we're gonna return new movie. Alright, that is add movie. And now let's import it here. Add movie, and we're gonna return add movie name and score. And that will be it for our mutation. Now let's check that out. Now what we're doing here, it's a query by default, but you could also do something like this. Query, right? That'll make it more exact. Query and query. Now we can also do mutation. So let's come here, mutation. And let's open our schema visualizer and refresh, because we haven't refreshed. As you can see here, now we have mutations. This is my favorite part about making APIs with GraphQL. This is why I like it so bloody much, because it's just awesome to be able to see what you have, what functions do you have, what the requirements are, and what you're going to return. Like that, it's amazing. Django doesn't have this out of the box. Any REST API doesn't have this out of the box, because it's hard to understand API. But once you define something like this, you can just call it and you understand the API completely, which is awesome. All right, so let's do mutation, create movie, add movie. And as you can see, I need the name, which has to be a name, has to be a string. So name, which movie do I like? Really, I don't know any movies. Trainspot, no. Rock and Roller. All right, and the score, 9. As you can see here, it's still bugging me because I need to select something for the return. As you can see here, it's gonna return a movie. It's gonna return the same movie. So in this case, I'm gonna get the name of the movie that I just added. And let's say, what the fuck, and name rock and roller, let's see, const in movie, name, score, resolvers, name, score, db, add movie, name, score, and add movie should return a new movie. Yes. Let's click here, and there is a problem. What is the problem? Actually, the error was on my server. Something happened with the address. The port was already in use. No idea. I just killed it. I console logged and it worked. There wasn't a mistake on my part. Happy for that. All right, so as you can see, it's working. And now, if I query movies again, save here, send. As you can see here, now Rock and Roller is added, all right? And we can keep doing that. Name, let me get the ID, all right? And here, name and ID. So that's it for a mutation. As you can see, so easy, like so easy, all right? Let's make one more mutation before we go. Or what time is it? It's 4 minutes, so let's delete the movie later. I hope you guys understand. Oh, it happened again. I hope you guys understand it. Oh, it has to be with no daemon. My God is telling me it's with no daemon. Yes, it is with no daemon. That's it for this video. I hope you understand what mutations do. I know it looks, I mean, in my opinion, it looks very beautiful. It's very functional, and you get the arguments here. GraphQL puts it there for you. You don't have to do anything. You don't have to to parse the body. You don't have to get a request. You don't have to get the parameters. Nothing. It's just there for you. And with GraphQL Playground, this is just awesome way of checking out your API. Okay, people, I will see you on the next one. So yeah, see ya there. Bye-bye.